Hello everyone, it's Michelle Patterson here with Angel Souls, and this is our daily card reading for January 21st, 2020. A very happy birthday to my sister Kim. I love you so much. And look at what we have here. Libyan Gold Tektite Manifestation. So this is that thing that says, be careful what you ask for. Make sure you want it, right? And this is also working a little, so manifesting in a wiser way, right? So a lot of times people will manifest things that they think will make them happy. And then when it doesn't, they can't believe it. Why am I not happy, right? It must be life's fault. This world, I just don't understand it. It must be someone else's fault. If they didn't do this, it wouldn't, I would be happy, right? So when we talk about what to manifest, this is asking you to be very aware of what will truly bring you joy. And just a hint, it's not usually something material. They're perfectly happy people who don't live in mansions or drive fancy cars. They're people who are out there pairing up with partners because they're more concerned about image than they are about being in love. Be careful what you manifest. I love telling this story. Years and years ago, I wanted to manifest love. And so the old way of telling people how to manifest was to really, and people still preach this, and it really bugs me. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I'll be very transparent. It bugs me. They're out there preaching that you have to think about what color eyes does your love partner have? What color hair? You have to be really, 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 really specific. We might go off on a tangent here in a minute. let's see if I can avoid that. But anyway, so that's what I did. Okay. I wanted somebody, who was successful, worldly. I kind of like the idea of someone who was a little bit older than me. And because at the time I didn't feel like I had any power whatsoever. Like I felt like everybody kind of ran me. I wanted someone who could be my protector. And almost like a bodyguard. You know what I'm saying? Like if somebody messed with me, this person wouldn't allow that, right? And there were some other things I wanted in this person. This person showed up and I went, whoa, I feel like a wizard. I just manifested this person. First of all, that person existed without you, okay, manifesting them. But this person comes in, we kind of join up, and I realize, oh yeah, if when you're playing the game of manifestation where you take the approach of be very, 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 very specific, you can miss details. And this is the tricky part about that technique. I forgot to say, hey, and don't be married. So this person showed up and was married, and I was like, dang it. But I had just put that frequency out. This person, despite being married, basically stalked me for years. It was a very scary thing. It was a definite lesson in be careful what you ask for. I was not interested in a married person. No, thank you. I'm not doing that. Goodbye. But they wouldn't take no for an answer. And then I had to do a lot of reversing of that energy because I had magnetized this person. Well, that's just how we put it. I don't know really scientifically what happened or if there's even a scientific explanation as to how our energy works. So having said that, I'm giving you that example for very good reason. Be careful of your approach to manifestation. And I would even dare say, be careful who you listen to. I've seen some of the most popular spiritual YouTubers out there who have a huge reach, and they're still preaching this way of manifesting and going, yeah, but look, it works. Sorry if you can hear that in the background. I'm in Colorado Springs. We have windstorms all the time. I'm next to a mountain. It just happens. They're still preaching this. And they're going, but look at my life. Look at how successful I am. Look at how beautiful I am. This is how I remain beautiful. This is how I remain thin. And oh my God, really? We missed something. Go back to the drawing board. All right? Go ahead and manifest today. But manifest from your heart. Manifest from pure intention. Manifest from a place where you trust the universe and say, universe, show me how good love can be. I'm not concerned what the person looks like. I'm not concerned what they do for a living. Just let us have a beautiful connection. And let the circumstances be perfect. Works for both of us and the highest good of everyone involved. And then leave it open. I know people are going to fight me on that and be like, that's not how you manifest. Good luck to you. Okay? Because when people manifest from the mental body, you'll get it because the mind is very powerful, but you'll have to pay for it. Probably dearly. And that's not to like fear monger, but I've experienced it. Okay. Like, yeah, you can manifest a lot of things, but there might be backlash for it. All right. Come from a pure intention, you know, manifest what would give you the kind of experience you want to have. All right. So we're going to leave it there, guys. I'm sending you so much love and take care. Bye-bye.